Welcome students, we are understanding subject verb agreement and we will understand the next rule. And according to this rule, when two singular subjects are joined by or nor, then they take singular verb. This is the next rule. When two subjects, when two singular subjects are joined by or nor, when two singular subjects are joined by or nor, then they take singular subject. Then we take singular subject. What is this singular subject? Let us understand through examples. No, nook or corner was left unexplored. Another example, neither the cat nor the dog was present there. Neither he nor his friend is to be blamed. Neither he nor his friend is to be blamed. So these are some of the examples, and in these you can see how the subject, singular subject joined by or, how the singular subject joined by nor, and how the singular subject joined by or, as you see in these examples, take singular verb, as is seen here. This is singular verb. So this is the this next rule. Now what happens next in the rule? When one of these two singular subjects is plural, suppose one of these two singular subjects is plural, then what will happen? Then the verb will take a plural one. The verb will be plural one if one of the subject is plural. So let us understand this rule. When one of the two subjects joined by or nor is plural, then what will happen? This is the next rule, or we can say this is the fifth rule. When one of the two singular subjects joined by or nor is plural, then the subject, then the verb will be plural. And this verb will be put near the this plural subject and put near the plural subject, or we can say here the plural subject is kept near the verb. And we put, it would be better if we say, and we put the plural subject near the verb. How? Let us see through one example. The mayor. Neither the mayor nor his counselors were present in the meeting. Neither the mayor nor his counselors. So here you can see mayor singular, counselors plural, joined by nor. Here they take plural verb and this verb is kept near the plural subject. This is the rule. Now let's move over to the next rule. This is yet another important rule, and which is similar and related to these two rules which we have just understood. What happens that when two singular subjects are singular but they belong to different persons, if such a thing happens, if the subjects belong to different persons, then how the verb will be written? If the subject belongs to different persons, then the verb will be as per the person which is near to it. Let us see. This is the next rule. When subjects joined by nor or are belong to different persons. Persons, then verb will be as per the subject put near to it. Verb will be decided as per the subject which is put near to it. Let us see. Two examples. Either you or I am mistaken. Either I or you are mistaken example, neither you nor he is to blame. Example 4, neither I nor he, neither I nor you. You take some other pronoun for understanding the difference. Are you are to blame. Now let us understand through these examples what is this rule. When subjects joined by, here what is happening when singular subjects, when singular subjects joined by nor or are belong to different persons, then verb will be as per the subject but put near to it. So here you simply keep it subjects. When two subjects joined by, because here you is considered singular and plural both, so you will get confused. So you simply say when two subjects joined by or not, because here you is singular as well as plural, so you will get confused. That would be better if you understand it as two subjects. So when it is joined by nor or are, then what happens? Here you can see that you, it is the second person, and I, it is the first person. So they belong to different persons. So here, according to I, this verb am is taken. Here I and you, I is first person, you is second person. And here the verb is taken as per the proximity to it, to you. Here the verb is near to you, so verb will be according to you, are. In this example, you and he, these are the subjects. And here the verb will be as per he, because it is near to he. Similarly, I and you, they are first and second persons, and verb will be according to you. So I hope you have understood this. Now we will move over to the next part. And before we move to the next part, here let me tell you that these two sentences, these two different type of examples, if in modern English they are written in some other way also, that is considered more appropriate. So how these are written, let us see. We will understand, it is, if we write these examples or we understand these sentences in this way, that would be more appropriate. Either you are mistaken or I am. This is called better English. If we say the same sentence in this way, this first one, if first one written in this way, either you are mistaken or I am. See another one. Either I am mistaken or you are, or you can write else, you can also write else. So this is better English. Either you are mistaken or else I am. Either I am mistaken or else you are. So this is better English in comparison to these sentences. If we write these sentences, that would be better. That would be considered better English. So this is example 1, example 2. Let us see example 3. Neither neither you are to blame nor neither you are to blame nor is he. Now see the fourth one, it can be written in this way, that would be better English. Neither I nor you are to blame. So neither I am to blame nor are you. So these sentences can be rewritten in better English like this. This is preferred. This is called better English. So I hope this rule is very clear to you. Now we will move over to the next rule. In this next rule, we will understand if certain words are used before the subject, then how the verb will be used, how the verb will be written. You know that there are certain special words, or we can say, which are considered mostly determiners, which give some idea about the subject. If everyone either neither each and many or if everyone either neither each and many are, these are used before a subject, then the verb taken will be singular. Are used before a subject, then verb taken will be singular. Let us see examples. Everyone of the hotels is full. Neither of the men is honest. Many a persons has achieved this feat. Mania. Either of the girls is hard working. Either of the girls is hard working. So let us have a recap of this rule. If everyone, either, neither, each and many are used before a subject, then what will happen? That the verb will always be singular. And here, these are the examples. Everyone of the hotels is full. Singular. Neither of the men is honest. Singular. Many a person has. Singular verb. Either of the girls is hardworking. So always a singular verb will be used. Now quickly we will understand one more rule before ending the class. We have just understood that if everyone is used before a subject, then verb is singular. And we have also understood a rule that if conjunction and joins two singular subjects, then the verb is plural. But the rule changes if each and every comes before the subject. How the rule changes? Let us see. If everyone or each is used before singular subjects and they are joined by and, they are joined by and, each or everyone is used before singular subjects and they are joined by and, then also the verb will be singular. Then also the verb will be singular in the sentence. Let us see. Example. Every boy and every girl was given a prize. According to the previous rule, singular subject joined by and take plural. But if they are preceded by every and every or each, then the verb will be singular. Example 2. Each man and each woman was given a set of tools. So this is similar example. Now we end this class. I hope you have understood, your understanding has grown. We will meet in the next class, then we will understand some more rules related to subject and verb agreement. So thank you, students.